Poppy did go for the four staff, but had that AA axe threat as well.
I'm curious to see if No-Tail does play Disruptor. Both of these heroes can be pretty passive in the early game. They really need their levels before they can really make a high impact, with the exception of like an early roam Chilling Touch, which we could still see again from Secret like we saw in the previous game. But as far as being able to move around the map early and really contest Lycan's farm, I don't know how good and valuable it could be from an AA and a Disruptor. They're not notoriously known for being heavy gankers early, so MY can feel like they have a little more clear in the early game on trying to build up their laning situation. So with that knowledge, I become more curious on how they're going to follow up with this fifth pick here. It's going to be what I'd imagine being their mid laner, the tempo controller, someone to potentially maybe even snowball out of control, and they also have to consider the anticipation on what the fifth pick for Secret could be. They're thinking it's going to be the Kuro hero, as they banned out the Morphling already, but we've also seen Kuro play Ember Spear, because they can always switch it there, but look at this, it's going to be Clink, wow. So that's a lot of greed. A lot of greed here. And that's a brood! That's a brood! The first real brood I've seen, at least from my own, in the most recent patch, in Captain's Mode, Team Secret. They're feeling spicy in this one, and we get to see the mother
I'm excited. Well, what do we have here? Really nice to see Team Secret unveiling. Of course, it's a pretty nice matchup for them to actually pull out a strat like that and really practice it competitively, because they feel already really confident against my insanity. Just that there's a skill gap between these players and they know it, so they want to draft to do something unpredictable and really throw my insanity off their game. Now Faceless Void will still be able to detect the Broodmother in Chronosphere, but otherwise they really don't have a great lineup against it. The Fade Bolt is their only AoE ability, other than I guess the familiar's stuns. Like, they do not have good ways to deal with these Spiderlings, and they're going to be all over these low heroes. Visage and Rubick, extremely low armor and low base movement speed. Simba is all day with this hero.
I'm so curious to see, and it wasn't that long ago I saw him playing it on his stream, you know, in pub style play, and I remember I was sitting there, and I even remember I chatted, I'm like, oh, Brood, huh? And I couldn't help but feel like maybe they're going to start incorporating in a few of their lineups and allow Simba to play it in the offlane position, and I guess I didn't have to wait very long, did I, Blazes? They're going to have to pull it out, and like you said, if more teams want to consider taking advantage of the Phoenix and the Brood now being brought in or back in to Captain's Mode, you got to be able to throw it into your loop at some point and try it out, and why not against a team like MYI? This is going to be our first glimpse into finding out how effective this hero can actually be in a lineup like this, and I'm excited for it, man, and we'll get ahead and underway, and without further ado, I'll just quickly roll through introductions on your side for MYI. I don't know why I always take the lead on introducing the teams. I don't really know. Try to butcher the hell out of their names, but I'll try it again here, Blaze. On the top lane, we got Bucktop, going to be playing your support Visage just behind. Actually, well, that's up and ahead already as they go from early aggressive movement here.
Oh, there's some looking No-Tail here.
This Rubick could scout out Telekinesis throwback here, but that is not going to be enough. No one really close enough, and being able to take advantage of that telekinesis. Now it's going to be Secret going back the other way, and both teams now are going to kind of play a little bit of footsie here, but neither one really committing. A very short range glimpse brings them right into a very nice chain. There's the Chilling Touch, and for the second game straight, we are going to see Secret acquire a very early first blood in the top lane onto MYI. And well, I guess before I finish that thought, I'll finish out the introductions. With that said, it's going to be Grazine Sensei playing your Klynx. Lycan is going to be played in the mid lane from Cole. And Rubick, who already pointed out, Lizard. And I guess that leaves your Faceless Void, Milan, playing your offlane Void.
But we see already Team Secret getting a nice little chain of advantages there. They were playing the Dance of Death, and they do get the glimpse off on the target they needed to. Skilling the Searing Chains pretty early, but gets them the kill they want. Same with the Gush, I guess. But now looking at Team Secret supports, it is going to be Puppy on your Ancient Apparition. Your Boots first Disruptor, played by Big Daddy No-Tail. He got the first blood, too, so he's really going to be rocking some early items. It's going to be Kuroki on the Ember Spirit. He's going to be the safe lane farmer, while S4 takes up the mid Tidehunter matchup against Lycan. Ah, you got to hate being that Lycan right there. The Kraken Shell, the Anchor Smash, both great tools against him. Of course, he did skill Gush for level 1. Bottom line, though, it's going to be pretty interesting here. Klynx is going up against Simba's Broodmother, and he's going to have a Soul Ring out very early on here. He's got Stout Shield. He's going to maybe go a little bit into the Incap Bite, since he doesn't really need hardcore HP regen, and it'll be a pretty good time for him. Not so much for Booktop up top, though.
No, Bucktop gets caught out right there. You see they're trying to contest this pull camp, but they don't really have the ammunition to do it. Seems like MYI's potential aggro tri lane not working out as good as they hoped, as even the side pull camp is now going to be contested from Secret. So they're off to a very strong start on this one. And well, Mother comes Blaze and makes her debut and what I'd imagine being in Star Ladder, and Simba going to be going against Klinks here. A familiar, or a matchup that maybe Klinks is not going to be so familiar with. I mean, Simba, who had been practicing this hero already, but I don't know if MYI are very used to actually going against the hero that often. Mm-hmm. We'll have to see.
At least for the start, it's going to be just both sides getting CS, because the Searing Arrows does allow you to get more offensive damage than defensive. But still, we see four denies coming out from Simba, so not too shabby. And he is going to get the Soul Ring out very early. I assume he's going to follow that up with Dust of Appearance if he wants to try to get a solo kill, but it's actually Grazine to bring the detection first. It's detection per purchased by the Visage, and he drops it down in his own lane down bottom to try to give him leverage in this 1v1.
We'll see how much he could put that to use going against this Brood and being able to harass him out from the lane, but as you see, he can kind of just hop into those trees and out from vision, but still be able to be in range to get some good XP. So just the more CS Brood gets out of this, it just makes it even the better. 8-4 CS on your offlaner solo, that ain't too bad at this point. But Glimpse back top lane, they're making another go on Visage, and they're gonna punish him once more. Ooh, Puppy will go down in exchange. The Soul Assumption will bring him down low enough so that the Faceless Void can clean it on up. It's gonna be a 1-for-1 trade between both supports. MYI just managed to finally get themselves onto the board, which is what's most important to them.
Now, I don't know if I even need to say this, but I'm not a fan of aggressive tri-lanes with Faceless Void. Like, I understand they're going to get run over by the Brood if they try to tri-lane down bottom. Like, they're not actually going to be able to zone out the Brood and actually will be feeding supports away. So, I don't think it's a bad call in general, but I do know that the Faceless Void is going to have limited contribution here in an offensive capacity. Gets one kill for himself, but many other core heroes in that situation would be able to return some more damage and actually get some more vengeance. Either way, on the mid lane, S4 will drop relatively low, but he's got Tangos, he's got Bottle, and I really think that Lycan's going to have a rough time here too. It's all three lanes going up Team Secret, and you can see it on the CS chart.
Yeah. This is great. I mean, Secret just seemed to be one step ahead. They anticipate the Lycan mid, so with the Tidehunter, who was their first pick, they just kind of flip it over. They're not going to go with the usual offlane Tidehunter. They bring it to mid, where he is clearly dominating. Top lane, though, that's where all the action's been, and it doesn't stop. They're making it go on Big Daddy right now. They got Kinetic Fields going to move him out a bit, but Big Daddy still goes down. Rubick is going to be traded for it. Now, jumping on forward, they're feeling it right now. Kuroki, long Soul Assumption does connect. They take down the Ember. They're going to do a little bit of harassment here on Puppy, who should be able to slip on out. But for the first time so far, MYI are going to be able to come out on top with two quick grabs. But here comes No Tail. See if he can get close enough. Puts out the Thunder Strike, but it's only level one Glimpse. Telekinesis again, and yeah, they don't really have enough at this point. They're still dancing with
Puppy's
the idea.
Dead.
Faceless
what
Void
is Puppy
looking
doing?
To get on in. Oh, first one bash right there. Oh, Cold Feet, however, it does freeze him. No, it does not. Time Leap's going to be there, and he takes down Puppy back on the other side. Visage, will he go down again? He certainly will. These supports can't stop dying at this point. We're already about 9 kills and 4 minutes in, and I'd have to say that they've all happened here
now
at the
top.
Now,
it's worth noting that there was a little bit of an RNG loss for Secret there. About a minute ago, there was a Searing Chains, and there was two supports and a Centaur in range. And of course, it hits the neutral creep, and the Visage gets to stay in the fight a lot longer. The Searing Chains actually would have forced him back, but instead, he gets another Soul Assumption off, kills off Kuro, and they start snowballing it from there. Another thing is that Puppy mispositions just out in the wide open there, up against a poor man's shield, Orb of Venom, Faceless Void. Milan gets to just keep him locked in place with bashes and with Orb of Venom slows, and now he's got phase boots up, which in of itself is pretty interesting, but when you're looking to pursue, when you're looking to chase, and when this is the target you want to go on.
Man, they are punishing Puppy. They anticipate him making his return to lane, and they cut him off and just take him down again. Unmerciful play from MYI. But can they make it out scot-free? Big question. Kinetic Field going to be dropped. They're trying to go right onto the secondary support, and they get that as well. Two supports now.
Ravage
on the side of Secret, and they are just playing ring around the rosy, but look who's here. S4 jumps in. Big Ravage does connect. They get the kill on Rubick, and they're going to get the other support. S4 with a very nice rotation from that mid lane. Kuro dancing in circles, baited them in just long enough. Look how low he got. Now he'll salve up ahead right back to the top lane. Good turnaround right there.
Clutch rotation coming in from S4 there, bringing in the Ravage right when they need it. I mean, Kuro walked away with like 20 HP by the end of it. Now we see down bottom Simba just chewing through this tower. Grazine is looking to deny this, but he's not actually going to drop it down below 10% here. Simba will build up his forces once more, get another wave to push on, and then last hit the tower when he knows the Klinks can't hold it. Now it's worth noting that the Spiderites do chaos damage, so they only do like they nerfed it. It used to be 40%, I think now it's 30% damage to towers. So he's got to last hit it with his own hero, but it's actually going to be the melee and range creeps from the Dire side to take it down, and Klinks is going to make his move elsewhere to the mid lane.
He goes to mid and they hand over bottom lane. That is scary. Your Brood is now 40-7 CS, overtaking everyone. Just behind S4 is Tidehunter. It's not very often you're going to see a Brood and a Tidehunter at the top of your CS charts and your net worth charts at that in a game at any given point, but they're really making it work right here, and Simba is going to get huge. And I can't help but feel like, is this going to be something where he just kind of plants himself in the bottom lane, or will he ever adventure out anywhere else, or is his job not done until he's in the base?
I think his job is to force TPs to the tier 3 down bottom, and then he can start making his move. With the new webs and the way the charge system works, he can actually leave a lane now compared to the old Brood who can't. Oh, it's going to be a Chronosphere onto Kuro only, and he's going to get glimpsed back. This wastes the Chrono almost entirely.
Wow, great spread right there from both Kuro and Big Daddy to go exactly top and bottom, and though they barely catch Kuro, that, like you said, man, that glimpse, and it just makes that Chrono nothing. So when MYI were hoping to make a big kill happen there on the top lane to punish Secret for only rolling with three, and as they commit Brood on bottom, they can't get the punishment. So they'll just have to continue farming it on up for now, and their bottom lane continues to just be a war zone that Brood is just making a home for. Now pushed against the tier 2 tower. Simba, what does he look to build up from here?
Looks like he didn't
say Orchid
any
probably.
Money. He's got Treads and a Soul Ring 6.
Oh, he's going right for
no
Klinks
dust,
here.
So he's not going to get the kill.
Didn't even level up the ult.
Yeah, that's actually pretty interesting. The ulti is actually usually really important, but because he maxed out his spin web, he has all the HP he would ever need. In fact, maybe a surplus of HP. A nice body block coming out from the spider. It's, will it get the cold feet? Yes, Cola's going down. Oh, the spiderlings,
wow.
The swarm. It just surrounds you and there's nothing you can do. Now in mid lane, they actually might be able to turn on them.
Ooh, glimpse all the way back, catches Rubick, and they just follow through. There's going to be the Gush right there, and a big Ravage that catches not one but two, and not one but two supports will be put into the grave. Team Secret off to a nice start in this matchup where they already are the heavy favorites. 11-6, winning all of the lanes. Just as more pressure begins to build up elsewhere and they want to finally start addressing the Spider, Kuro will just keep on farming in the top lane on his Ember. Mid lane, though, Telekinesis pullback here by S4. They don't have the Ravage anymore, so technically this would be MYI's best chance to make a fight happen, but they really can't find where to take a good fight because they need their own time to farm. Lycan has got his mask right now, but he still needs to throw together his Vlads. I don't see really an opportunity where MYI would be able to do a Roche pretty easily unless they somehow take a fight, but this Brood will always be in the bottom part of the map and could easily contest a Roche, I'd imagine, with these webs.
Every 40 seconds she gets a new web to work with, so she's putting it all over the jungle. You see there's none that were, the ones that were used to be by her tier 1 tower on the bottom lane have been just collapsed. You can click on those and actually just tell them to destruct, so you get to choose which ones go, which ones stay, and he's got this kind of creep spread going to this bottom lane. So he controls the jungle, he controls the lane, and as we mentioned with his skill build, he has so many webs to work with, he has unlimited HP. The only thing he's lacking is that passive. The incapacity invite is actually really powerful, but he'll get there soon enough. I mean, he's about to hit level 10, that'll be 1 point in it, and once that gets maxed out, I don't think anything could stop him.
Oh, they want to make a go here. Kinetic Field. Static Storm is going to be used and a glimpse back, but he just time walks over that and he wants to make a go on Big Daddy. He still has the Chrono if he wants to use it here, and he will, just to secure the support kill. But S4 jumps across. No Ravage, but they will be able to get a trade of supports. But, walking through the tower, eating some pretty big damage. Faceless Void here. Can he get away from this one? Time walk into the woods. Can he TP away from this one? Nope. Secret, immediately where he goes. And they just follow him on in there and take him down. No mercy. And Clank's bottom lane, so wounded from just trying to battle through these spiders and bottom lane, is going to be forced to have to make his walk all the way back to base where Simba just has made his home, yeah. And he's just laughing. My lane now.
And I mean,
yours.
What can you really do? You've got Fade Bolt to cure this disease that is spreading over the bottom lane. Like, that's all you've got. And he will pick up like 3 spiders off of that Fade Bolt, but it gets weaker with every bounce. And now Rubick's like dead. The incap bite would guarantee the kill.
He's like, come to my web. Come into my web, my pretty.
I'm not.
Nope. Can't get it that time. The dust is
gonna
connect.
He's so fast, though.
In case Clinks wants to. Yeah, no. That's just. I don't think they could do anything. The bottom lane is now plagued, and they're going to need to commit a lot for it. Now, they do move forward. They get the one hit brash, and wow, they're connecting a lot of right click from the high ground from Clinks. Space created, though, for Simba as he just keeps them held down here. At least 3 members. Allows top lane to be free and easy farm for Secret. You can see right over here, S4 is on the way. He's got a Ravage at the ready, and they still can't even take Simba down. Just hides himself into the trees and slowly heals himself back
up. I think
up.
Ruby actually would have died there if there were 1 or 2 points in incapacitating bite, but nevertheless, he just forces them back off the lane. That's all he has to do is just continue to force. If he pops his ultimate here, he can man up against Clinks, Soul Ring or not. And actually, it's going to be, the Tide coming in to help out. This could be a kill. Well, they don't have the detection, so he is going to be able to just sneak out of there. No. But if they had caught him with the Ravage or under the Sentry Ward, then that would have been a kill.
I was expecting him to just pull out the Ravage just to get the kill. I mean, it's Clinks, you know. He's like one of their better late-game potentials. Why not, right? I think it would have been well worth it, but they're not going to go for it. They were maybe hoping he would just get reckless and not even go invis, but that's not going to be the case. So now MYI just kind of running around the map, looking for what their potential groove could be for this game as they continue to get pressured about. Net worth still held at the top from S4 with Simba's Brood just behind.
Disruptor, though.
Kuroki, a slower start from what we usually seen for his farm, but he's creeping his way back up in there with how much time he's had top lane. But top lane seems to be the next target for MYI. Clinks is in stealth mode, seeing if he can maybe scout.
They have to
out.
Save the Chronosphere for the retaliation. They have to Chrono the Tide when he goes in for a counterplay. Right now, it doesn't have a TP scroll, but he still has that Blink Dagger and a Haste Rune. He can move to the top lane in about 10 seconds flat, and he's actually going to be making his way up there as we speak.
There we go. Ice Blast is also going to kind of set the stage. Does connect there on like an immediate rotation glimpse. Can I get it? Can they get the vision? That's what Kuro's looking to get for right here. Is Big Daddy doesn't actually step out from the trees to really go for it nonetheless, but they do get their mega kill as they take down S4. Clinks inherits that bit of extra bounty and now moves forward onto Big Daddy, who pops all of his spells but goes down. Will those spells help out and take it out Clinks? No, they will not. Even Kuro with his DD now pressured, moving on in. Is going to be your Faceless Void. No Chrono, but no needed. A few more right clicks and they actually manage to clean this up here. So taking down 3, very significant fight here for MYI as they begin to move on to his tier 2, but bottom lane, Brood continue to farming, doing what she likes here as she's already going to probably secure the tier 2 herself. I don't think it's too terrible of a trade from Secret, though they do lose their Ember
Spear. Mid lane Booktop is going to take some hits here. It should be an easy duo kill. Like, they can go and glimpse them right back into it, and they've got a lot of damage between these two heroes. So Booktop doesn't even throw out the Soul Sergeant, almost AFK, but yeah, in either case, he was dead. I still think that it was a really nice move for MYI to get the Chronosphere onto the Tide, and that's the only hero you really can't afford to Chrono now, because if you Chrono, like, the Ember Spirit or something, the Tide's going to come in and ravage you and nullify that and then turn the fight around. But they get the top tier 1 at the cost of their bottom tier 2, and Simba's going to force them to TP to the tier 3 now. He's got his Necro up, he didn't go Orchid or any fighting build, he just wants to keep playing the split push, and it's going to be very frustrating for a team that has, again, absolutely no AoE. They have to Chronosphere to kill the Brood too. I mean, it's just painful, but she's going to be forcing at least a couple TPs back. Hasn't really started chipping away at the tier 3 just yet, but it creates space for them to bring down the tier 1 in mid.
Yeah, Brood's one of those heroes that you reserve for your 5th pick in situations like this when you know she can really run amok and not really be punished whatsoever. Picking up early on just really sets an opportunity for teams to easily be able to counter. Legion Commander is like one of the first ones that comes into my mind that could really do well work here, but they go right past the tower and they do commit a couple of ultimates here to be able to finish off Visage, but they do get a Jund. Big Daddy, though, is going to be paying with his life for it as Lycan cleans him up. Now Ravage going to be coming out. Does catch nicely on 3. Uh-oh, it's going to be taken away here from Rubick, and they use it on the go-back, going on Kuroki. Chrono also going to be pulled out for this one as Kuro goes down. They lose 3 again for the 1 Visage. Very nice grab right there from Rubick to take that Ravage back, and, well, the Chrono certainly helps being able to secure the kill on Ember.
Very worth it for the kills they did acquire, but now they have to be worried about their bottom lane. Brood is extremely confident that she's going to be able to go in and just maul down this tower. It's 50% damage from these spiderlings against fortified structures. That's from 50% to 40%. So Broodmother, since that nerf, was like out of the meta for a very long time, but she's back in now and she's still doing quite a bit whenever they leave that tower alone. So without big ultimates like Ravage and Chronosphere, they have to rotate down and play very, very defensively. They do take down the tier 1 just barely with Lycan's Wolves, but otherwise they're just really not able to leave their base and take objectives across the map like you would want to do with a Visage Lycan lineup.
Yeah, they're working pretty hard just to even get these tier 1s. Fortunately for MYI, well, not fortunately here for Visage, as he's glimpsed all the way back. Your Visage already 3-9, now 3-10 after that whip pickoff right there. Is really struggling to be able to put together the farm himself. I'm not imagining a future of an Agnum Scepter anytime soon here if you're the blue player. But unfortunately, we'll see Secret, where Simba has been residing in this bottom lane, is finally going to get some attention, at least from the Lycanthrope. Lycan, by the way, did find a kill there in the mid lane, taking down Puppy's AA, but Simba now scouting out. Side-by-side farming with Klinks, it looks like. Now they turn their sights over. Simba eating huge damage, but baits him in long enough for Big Daddy to come on through. That's huge damage with the ultimate, and now Simba steps back, gets some right-clicks in. No! Yes! There it is. The last Thunderstrike can be able to get it right there, but now they have the dust on their turn, scouting out Simba, but Rubick, you're just one man! And he gets blown the hell up. That was not a fight that you could take, sir, not without assistance from your Lycan, but who's going to be glimpsed back in into the kinetic field? TP's out immediately, and that's a smart choice as Kuroko flies through. Kuroki flies through. He didn't have the mana anyways for the chains, but still.
I think he popped it like in the middle of his animation, but he just wasn't close enough, and the Lycan does slip through, but you don't man fight a Brood when he's got his ulti up. This insatiable hunger just makes it impossible for them to bring him down. He can bait all day long, and end of the day, when you try to duel him, he's going to come out ahead. Milan now looking for the Chronosphere play up against this where he popped the Mask of Madness, but only to get Ravaged, Anchor Smashed, and right-click down. He will not get away.
Oh,
no Chrono for you, and S4 blinks out of the bird stuns.
Wow. Secret have been doing that a lot this game, baiting in MYI into a situation where they think they have the advantage, and then help is right there. And it happens again here. Jump forward, Gush. They're going to go for Lycan. They know Shapeshift is down, and he was hit with that Ice Blast, but not enough damage to really bring him into Danger Shatter Zone. But still pressure nonetheless here on the top lane to keep Lycan busy because, well, bottom. That's where Broodmother continues to build on up. Now with Necro 3 complete on Brood, there is at no point that you can leave this bottom lane unattended because she's going to get what she wants, but it looks like the next thing Team Seer want altogether is a Roche. Meanwhile, mid lane, engagement onto S4 here. Soul Assumption flies out, eating big damage from Klinks. S4 could be in trouble.
Close call. The Wolf canceling the Blink Dagger. No, he doesn't get the right click off.
Oh.
Visage pause coming through. A ping issue for the Rubick here. And in the meantime, of course, Roche is going to go down quickly. Now, I find it really cool to watch these spiderlings when they run through the web. It didn't used to be like this, but when they run through the web now, they actually get the benefit of it. The invisible effect, the phased movement speed, and then, of course, increased movement speed. So they get to clump up all together, and there's this like tiny clump of dozens of spiders. And as soon as they leave the web, they just like spread out very, very abruptly. So it's just very interesting to see how it looks when they move around and just skitter about the map.
Yeah, and also the health regen as well, I'd imagine here. And yeah, Broodmother, something you don't get to see very often, but we do welcome it here with open arms. And of all the people to pick it on up, I was curious which team was going to look to throw in their loop, and it was right in front of my eyes here. Simba on his offlane position. Once you're given the opportunity to grab it and there's not a lot of counter out there, Brood has been pretty much showing what she could do best and what has plagued many of us pub players when that one person who just loves to play Brood comes into your game. And even though you feel strong about taking team fights and you're winning, you realize that you're only winning because it's a 5v4 and you lost your racks on the other side of the world. And Simba looking to do a little bit more of the same with Necro 3 complete. Makes it easier for them to kind of move on and get Roche. But then thereafter, if he ever gets the opportunity to move it into the high ground of the MYI base, he can get what he wants very quickly.
Now, to the benefit of those that aren't really familiar with how to deal with the Broodmother in pub play or whatever, a couple of old counters that we got to see back towards 2012 when the hero was extremely popular, we got to see 1v1 matchups featuring Tidehunter, because he has the Anchor Smash, Sand King, because he has the Caustic as well as Sandstorm, the Darkseer was really good with Ion Shell, and more recently we've seen Legion Commander added, and she's really good with the Overwhelming Odds. There's a couple others out there. You have to take the Acid Spray from Alchemist, which can be frustrating and stuff like that. But what you run the risk of when you draft all this AoE against her, assuming she didn't just get fifth picked when you didn't have the choice to counterplay. That's four playing with fire there is up against a void. But if you actually get the chance to draft against her instead of her getting fifth picked, what you run the risk of by drafting too much AoE is that she actually just goes for one of these newer builds, which is just no spiderlings at all. Actually, Simba gonna take some hits here. They have the sentry. They will be able to bring him down for the first time this game. A very nice kill.
Yeah, they commit a lot for it this time. They're well prepared with the birds, with the sentries, and there's nowhere your pesky brood can go once spotted out. Doesn't really have the ease of access to just kind of make an easy retreat. Pincered right there into the trees. They do finally take down that brood, but hey, your brood is about to reach the 10k network mark. And they push up here in the top lane. Meanwhile, mid lane, you can see a quick grab right there. Uh-oh, follow through. Ravage coming through. S4, thinking maybe he can man up here on your faceless Void, is going to try his best to run him down, but Void with a time walk at the ready. Oh, Gloss is backing away from Daddy. Does he see him?
Oh, so close. You have to be inside.
He can't
quite see
him.
You have to be inside the circle. Thunderdome there, but no, he's able to jump away. Unfortunately, S4 stacks the Ravage on the Colty. He wasn't sure if it was actually going to proc, if he was within the range when he was running out, so he just wanted to guarantee it with the Ravage. They got that long duration stun, but they didn't have enough damage with him alone, so nice sneak away, and yeah, unfortunate on the attempted glimpse there. So yeah, Puppy has died so much this game, 6 deaths on him. A lot of them have just been like solo chronos or solo jumps from the Void, and there's really nothing you can do.
Uh-oh, Kuro gonna get a little bit of his own medicine, something Kuro loves to do on his Clinks, but even though the Orchid's there, it's going to secure the first Aegis life. Your Ember Spirit marked for one death. Klinks knows it's going to happen, doesn't even pursue. Knowing that just how the trend has been going from Secret is you get one great grab right there, it's not going to be too much further away that you're going to see a couple more Secret members looking to come and get their own. So I like the idea of him not getting too greedy about hunting down where Kuro went. And sure enough, there was help right there from both Puppy and Big Daddy. But now they're out for blood. They put their smoke and they inch on forward here. Klinks is here in the top lane. Obviously, they don't see him, but they do have Dust in case he does show himself and they want to make the move back.
I think that Simba's actually going to be going for a Heaven's Halberd here. Now, obviously, the Broodmother is an agility hero, but who?
Oh, Blaze, huge fight, breakout top lane, another Chrono to take down big old Puppy. And now they're moving on No-Tail here. Huge soul assumption. He pops his Dust and glimpses back Klinks. Nope. Barely lives. One more auto attack. They do get it. Glimpse back. Klinks sees S4 and we'll try to hunt him down. Oh, Faceless Void is here. Whoa, Time Weave's way out there and away. And, with no
what's
chrono,
the TP status?
Really
can they actually
S4
defend
down
their bottom lane? TP is up on Void, but he's pushing up top. And, this Brood is actually going to get some good damage here onto the tier 3 tower. Fortification is going to be forced.
S4 doesn't have a Ravage to prevent them from making a getaway, unfortunately, but they are pretty much focused on trying to take this tier 2 quickly. Bottom lane, here we go. Mother moves on in to the high ground and begins to unleash a Fury with only a Rubick to defend. He is certainly going to need a bit more assistance. Your tier 3 now brought down to about half life. Your top tier 2 will actually still live. For now, they're just kind of holding it about, but they need to make a decision quickly as far as what they want to do for MYI. This bottom lane either needs assistance or they need to make a big play happen here on top.
Yep, so it's going to be dropping extremely low. I'm not sure if Simba will actually be able to finish off this tier 3, though. They have the fortification. They can TP back with the Void, but with the Chrono already down, yeah, he's not going to be doing too much. Simba will just walk away from this. But they do get the top tier 2. The Tide did not have enough mana to really contest it. And,
They make a jump onto Simba. Mask of Madness is going to be pop. Time walk forward. Simba trying to retreat, moving up and far away. Can't get out of the vision path. Oh, one more right click. Going to be right there. Milan does get it done. And just a nice grab once more on your Brood. Simba's work before he got taken out was taking down that tower very, very low. One more move like that, and he's going to have the Rakdos exposed and the damage start coming in. Puppy able to get himself out of a potential bind right there with the Force Staff. Klinks. It only took like 2 shots to bring him down to like a third life.
And that's why sometimes you see actually Mantis style picked up on Broodmother. You can obviously take the dust off when you use the activation to dispel yourself, but there's so many issues with the Chronosphere gems, sentries, that isn't always the best solution. He's just going to be building up this Talisman of Evasion. I think that is going to be a Heaven's Halberd, really good against the Clinks in particular. You look at it, Brewmother, yes, she's an agility hero, but she's a hero that naturally has a ton of damage. You get 100 bonus damage from Insatiable. All you need to do is live long enough for your life steal to really kick in. So I actually like the Halberd option if she can get it. And of course, this is only his second death, so he's had a pretty good farm game so far.
Seeker rotate to the bottom to see if they can get a hold of anyone, but they had already TP'd on out. They head back, and they will be able to see a DD rune down here. Grab for them if they want to put it to strong use. So Void, with an Agnums now, very much favoring the Chronosphere and being able to put it to use, as he's put many a use onto Puppy's Head, being able to find those kills. They continue to farm up the secret jungle, and Simba, who had been taken down previously in the bottom lane, makes her return back to the bottom lane. Talk about building up a Halberd. I would not mind seeing that grab right now, especially against that Clink. So,
oh, Milan.
We'll see here. Smoked up, though. They move in, and they're going to make a go here on Faceless Void. You cannot farm our jungle. Not without paying for it. So they take down Void, and they move on in. Nice glimpse grabbed right there. They want a second one with Visage, but just as that happens, well, they're going to get it. They move on forward. Visage
bottom
does
lane,
go
Rubick
down.
Is going to be going
Simba
down to the spiders alone. They got the sentry wards, but he just can't keep himself up. And the dust is going to dispel onto Simba. The orc will come out, but just too late. He invises once more, walking right back under that sentry ward.
Wow, Secret getting it done. Top in their own jungle, taking down a couple. And Simba withstands and gets a kill himself here on the bottom lane. Just more or less Secret still getting the most out of what they want.
Oh, Necro
Clink
sees
so
Clink's
Orca together.
He's not going to be able to get him, though.
Necrobook out now. He needs to be very, very careful. Yeah, he's crossing over here. He's going to walk right into the Necro Vision, but Simba is not going to commit for anything quite
chomp
yet.
Chomp.
Oh, he's eating so much.
Yeah, he
damage,
actually
though
got the death will of the Necronomicon when he killed the melee one. Is this actually going to bring him down? Yes, he's going to go down to that spider, small spiderlings.
Oh,
he eats the melee Necro creep, which does heal him because of death pack, but it also damages him with the pure damage nuke even more so that he does take a huge chunk of damage. Then the ice blast, of course, comboed with the big damage nuke, and sayonara, Mr. Bonefletcher.
Good work right there. Just a little careless right there from Clinks, forgetting that bit of global oomph coming out from Secret side. Karak's going to briefly cross pass with Void, just chains him down and goes back to his merry way of building up farm. Touching base with Kuro on his Ember. He has that Battle Fury complete and about 300 gold here as he continues to farm up through his own jungle. He'll constantly have Puppy by his aid. No Tails here as well, because they don't have to worry too much about the bottom half of the map, where Simba's been not only claiming the bottom lane, but also taking a lot away from MYI's jungle. Lycan begins to push out this bottom lane just a little bit, but here we go. Refresher orb already thrown together from S4.
27 minutes on this mid tides refresher, and he's got everything to support it. This is insane.
Ice Blast comes through, doesn't really quite connect on anyone, but it's clear Secret are looking to move on into the jungle. You're gonna briefly see with the Necro Book. Faceless Void on the way out. Oh, Big Daddy wanted to get that one with the glimpse. They won't see the vision here, and he does make it out. Very dangerous play coming out from your Faceless Void, but he is able to make an escape, and Lycan pops his shapeshift just to kind of retreat back to the base area.
Unfortunately, he's gonna need... Oh, well, actually, he does get a little bit of move speed on his shapes to try to pound down his tier 1 tower, but he's not going to finish it off. Not because of backdoor protection, that doesn't exist for tier 1 towers, but just because the creeps aren't really that strong at the moment. His howl wasn't active on them either, but I think at this point Cole just has to like run down mid. Like, he has to try, because they know they can't fight 5v5 against the double ravage, they just have to start ratting as hard as possible. Just push down top, push down mid, get away from that 5-man play. But it's going to be Milan onto Simba here. Can he even bring him down?
I don't think so. Not with that Ravage coming out. Now Mulan's going to be the one taken down, and it's a killing spree for Simba. Felt like he was just taken down not too long ago, and now they look to wait it about. They want to try to farm up the birds. They do get one. They get two. 100 more gold right there into the pocket of Big Daddy on his Disruptor. Team Secret coming out with a big 2-for-1 trade after Puppy got picked off in the mid lane. It's Clinks going on pickoff duty as he could get another here. The Orchid.
Yep.
Nice. Will secure it. He TP's out right next to the dead corpse of that Disruptor, Two big grabs right there for your Clinks. So we'll see here as Secret continue to pressure about this bottom lane. Simba with a full army of creeps. And his old nemesis, the Rubik, still on defensive duty with that Fade Bolt.
I actually have to call into question the Aghanim Scepter pickup of the Faceless Void here. Like, I understand that Chrono is extremely valuable to picking off the Ember Spirit, but at the end of the day, they don't have that much damage to put into the Chrono. The Void only has a Mask of Madness. The only other ranged DPS is going to be the Flinks, and he's not always going to be there doing his own thing very frequently. Oh, big, easy kill on Rubik as all the spells hit him at essentially the same time. But yeah, if this Void had, like, a Maelstrom or a Battle Fury, he'd be able to deal with the spiders a lot better, and he would actually have damage in this fear. So, especially when he's level 16, and that difference between Ags and not Ags is only 30 seconds instead of like 50, I think it'll be very unfortunate the Void just doesn't have the deeps.
Almost a pickoff right there for Clinks. He got a lot of shots in, prolonging the use of the Orchid there at the end, which was great, but still just a little too fast. Kuro was able to walk away from that Clinks and make it out alive. Your Ice Blast, though, comes in bottom lane, not going to quite connect on either. Very well spread here, but look at this. I mean, it's Simba just doing what he wants. He takes the one Rex down pretty dang low. He has the safety net of S4 and company just behind, so he can kind of move in there and do as he pleases, but here we go. His Secret looking to take the high ground with Rax is already exposed, and that melee Rax about dead. This is their time to take the fight. They move in. Chrono only going to catch on Big Daddy, and that's not going to be enough. They do take him down with Klinks' right click. And now they focus fire Simba. Telekinesis just up and above, then pulled on back and away here. Still waiting. S4 silenced up, nursing that Ravage for now, as it's not really necessary. They take down that first set of racks, but look what's happening on the other side here, Blaze. Up and above, Lycan doing a little bit of his own Lycan thing, going for two sets of racks himself. He's got one, and he's going for the second. Meanwhile, on the bottom, Kuro gets a kill, cleaning up and taking down that Rubik, and they follow through with a secondary grab right there, finishing out the Visage. So it is possibly going to look like two racks for two racks, as Lycan did finish his job there at the top lane. Secret, they do take more casualties.
Yeah, but I think they're going to be able to rebound a little bit faster here. Simba will get healed up, and they can just rush for the tier 2 in mid. They've got one Ravage, and in 40 seconds they'll have another. So I think they're going to be able to be ready for the next fight a little bit sooner, but nevertheless, it was a really smart play from the Lycan, taking the top lane. As I was mentioning, their only way they win this one out is through rat play or some crazy pickoff on S4.
Let's see if they can do it. They still have one Ravage ready, 20 more seconds. They could have two. I imagine they'll wait for that point, also pinging out the fact that Roche is up, so I guess making it all the easier if they can grab that extra life, and then with two sets of Ravages, or just two Ravages, they'll be able to move on into the MYI base and finish what they started, already taking out that bottom lane. They now secure a very, very hard team fight to kind of counter against, and MYI, a team that's kind of only digging deep for maybe some rat and split push play. I have seen it done before, Blaze. I'd have to tell you, Power Rangers on the back of Ditya Ra certainly put together an attempt his own, but this is going against Team Secret here, and Clink's trying to do some side farm. He's going to get quickly punished with a Ravage and even a Static Storm just to make sure he gets nothing that he wants.
He
is down now for a full minute. Yep, jump in. They get the Chrono out. Ice Blast perfectly set on top here to take on the Void, and they can't do anything. They can't see him, and he just goes under the cover of his own web, and that was all for nothing. Now jumping on forward, S4 with a DD rune, Visage. No chance whatsoever for that, and will be killed. And
The big glimpse back.
Rubik, nice glimpse grab from Big Daddy. They get another one, one after the other. Secret, mow down MYI, and it's looking like another split push effort coming from your Lycan, but this is going to be an easy mid lane push.
The Chronosphere has a cooldown in theory is what you need to kill off a lot of these heroes here, and having it on 60 second cooldown sounds good, but if you can't actually kill anybody in the Chrono, it just doesn't matter. You're always going to have to worry about that Ravage on the fringe edges of it, and you just have 140 damage right clicking Void going up against a Butterfly Broodmother. You're not killing him. You just aren't. And now you're feeling the weakness.
Big Daddy gets the glimpse, they kept out Void, and they use their second Ravage for it. Now he gets hit with the Ice Blast, but he goes right back with a Chrono. He wants to get someone. He does get down Big Daddy, but can he make it away? He does leap over and around, but nope, he ends up getting shattered. Just brought down too low with the Ice Blast already on him. Nothing you could do about it. Clinks, though, back from the dead. Moves on in, sees Puppy, gets a few shots in. And, he needs to finish it off. Does blink over. And, oh, we'll get it right there. Puppy kind of making him work for it right there on the back end of that Ghost Scepter, and now they're going to make a go on Clinks. Kuro leading out the front, Remnant forward, and he's going to, oh, gets caught. Nice chains and sleight of fist from Kuro. Secures the kill there on Clinks. Still would buy back available, however, on your Clinks. I guess it is preventing them from pushing
nice
on into the
from
base.
Cole with the top lane being pushed in. Backdoor protection was broken, so he sent his entire army to the mid lane, took the tier 3, took half the range rack's life, but in the end he does get finished off, though Nutail will have to kite away from these super creeps. He's going to survive. And yeah, as you mentioned, they will have buybacks, so they won't be able to push the base, but they won't be able to take direct fights, and there's going to be Secret moving right into the Roche pit with all three lanes pushed out so that the Lycan can't go out to play again.
And here they go. They'll bring it down pretty dang quick. Simba flexing that butterfly, putting it to strong use with a plate mail and 2k gold. Probably looking to throw together a nice little AC for himself and for the team. And what we'll see here is it's still Secret's game. But MYI with their cheeky tactics, trying to bring it back with some side push tactics here. Actually have added more pressure onto the base itself than Secret have done. But Secret have shown that they can get the fight when they want it with these big, big ultimates. And now Roche going down. It is going to be Simba who picks up that Aegis and waltzes Mother right back towards the enemy side.
It looks like the Lycan is going to be going for an AC2 to counteract the AC that will be coming from the Broodmother. Very powerful for him pushing, for him fighting. But if he goes for it right now, he cannot afford to buy out. Like, he has buyback available now, but if he tries to complete it, he likely will not have it. And that's one kinetic field pickoff from killing him off. He does have the BKB, and there is no Aghanims up on No-Tail, but they still have so many tools for locking him down. And yeah, he has to be very, very careful about every movement from this point forward in the game. He needs to keep that gold for AC, but he also can't be picked off.
Trying to go for a backdoor play here as the Wolfman
and Broods in mid too.
Creeps on forward, going to get put into a kinetic field. Oh, nice quick juke there from Big Daddy, and the Chrono's not going to happen. Now a Ravage, follow through. Static Storm's not going to be offering a whole lot, but it's enough. They take down Visage. Sidestepping it away is going to be your Faceless Void. They're heading right back towards the base where they feel like pressure could be coming from Simba. Simba now on the way out, steps away briefly. Now makes a go. Faceless Void with no more
Chrono. Here it comes.
Very, very slow, and jump in Ravage number two. Faceless Void will be brought down right there. A few more right clicks coming through as Simba really flexing out this Broodmother. There's your glimpse back. Rubick not going to be in the safety of his own home. Will be taken down. Three down all day now for the side of MYI. Trying to pull out a backdoor play in that mid lane, but Secret were onto him. And now Secret with this big team fight advantage move right into the base and go knocking tier three. Back from Rubick, but this is probably the last hurrah for MYI as Secret just kind of continue to get what
exactly
they want.
Simba forced the Lycan to TP back, and as soon as that happened, the chance for them to take the enemy base was gone. Just too much power from the Brood, pressuring the bottom lane, keeping Clinks farming instead of fighting, because he really loved to be ganking around that 15-20 minute mark. And then when it came down to it, they kept on having to respond to him down bottom, now in mid, and they just can't make the plays that they want to. On the back of S4's incredible Tide underplay, Simba has been able to do wonders, and across the board, Team Secret have absolutely just run over MYI. Now Void's coming back up. He does have the Chronosphere, and one Rex is still standing in mid, but not for too long.
Not for too long at all, as it is going to be taken apart right there. So two Rex now down on the side of MYI. Very well wounded. Secret go back. Lycan on the hunt. Oh, Puppy. Four staff to the low ground to step away from that one. Big Daddy's also here if he needs to glimpse someone back, but he might put out an offensive glyph, make it a go on mid lane here if they want to. Stepping forward, Static Storm, chains will hold him there. Kinetic Field, Cold Feet, the works. And just as Faceless Void comes back to fight, he goes back down again. They do manage to take down Big Daddy, but they also lose their Clinks. Simba continues to wrap everyone up in his little
check
web
out mid,
and just
Dire.
Suck the blood right
Cole's
out from this
going
team.
In for the backdoor play. They're going to TP back, see it coming, but how well do they defend it? Kuro going 1v1 against him, killing off the Wolves, and popping the Fortify very early as their Tier 4s are also under assault. Simba's going to be in the mid, but he has nothing to kill here. It's all about this Lycan, and he is going to be going down. Didn't even pop the BKB, just instant. No shapeshift, no nothing. He falls, and with him, I feel their hope of bringing this one back. They're down significantly in terms of racks, and they obviously can't take the fight.
He's not looking to give up yet. He obviously didn't use his shapeshift. He has the buyback so that when he buys back, because he'll probably have to here, he has a full minute left before he does return. He can pull out that shapeshift at that point and try to put up one last hurrah as far as defense. But the only person looking to go more offensive right now is Simba and S4 as their dynamic duo. With a one Ravage at least at the ready here. Ice Blast will not quite catch. Had that been caught when they were close enough, I imagine a Blink Forward Gush nuke from Simba would have been good enough. But Simba alone here, still in the base, uses that Necrobook to take out all Sentry Wards. He takes out a Tier 4, and he has been plaguing this home base from MYI. All game long, like you were talking about before, forcing MYI to not spend enough me time and farming up. Klinks, ever since he got his Orchid, couldn't really put anything else together because they constantly had to move back to the base and prevent the Brood from really getting on in there. And it just proves to work out so nicely in this secret lineup.
And every
lineup.
Point in time where Secret were dictating the pace of the game, Kuro was able to do what he wanted. He's actually accrued 13 kills and 14 assists, and it's because, you know, when you're committing two heroes down bottom constantly, that enables the Ember to go for 3v3 plays and to shine in that environment where he's not being controlled too much. So, yes, theoretically, with like three or four heroes moving against him, they'll kill him off 9 out of 10 times, but when most of those heroes are committed down bottom, Kuro just gets to do whatever he wants. So, not to understand his play, but it's been a pretty easy game for him.
Oh, they were trying to see if they could get Klinks on the way back. They got an Ice Blast on, and he quickly popped out the BKB. Try Remnant, but here we go. Chrono catches him out, and they do get the kill there, taking down Big Daddy very nicely as he tried to move through the secret shop trying to glimpse back Klinks, but does end up paying with his own life. Now Team Secret here in the top lane. We'll see what their next move could be. This is the last lane standing for MYI. Well, Lycan pushes down this mid lane, would love to be able to get himself back into Secret's
base. The creeper's
base,
gonna get there. I don't think anybody's gonna cut down this way, so the backdoor protection will be broken down, but what he does with it is the real question here. We have S4L could be picked off here. They have Chronosphere coming up in 20 seconds, but for now, he is just gonna be Anchor Smashing, Force Staffing as best he can to survive, and will commit one Ravage, maybe two with the Ice Blast.
Here we go, there's one, there's the two! Oh, Visage is going to crumble just like that, and though they lose S4, they're looking to fight on here. Rubick steps on back and away, but it is going to be Cole who does get the clean up. AA falls, and mid lane, where Simba is, could be in a bit of trouble here.
Yeah, that
so
butterfly.
Tanky, just avoids all that damage. That butterfly is just like, no problem, walks away. This spider. Someone needs to call the Orchid Man, the pest control, to be able to help with this one, because proven to really be farmed out of control at this point as a void. Now with still Chrono ready, not having to expend it in that previous fight, this is MYI's best chance at moving into the base and getting what they can done.
It's going to be a quick buyback, plus Shiva's Guard coming up for S4. Wants to do some work even without the Ravage available. They are going to glimpse back Cole. He doesn't have a BKB. Expended it to stop the Black Hole, but the Chronosphere comes through.
All right, it does come through. He's still eating so much damage. That Ice Blast, though, not even necessary. Simba's able to finish it off with the right clicks alone. And now, Faceless Void, no Chrono. He already used it. Time Walk, Desperation, TP. Can we get the Sleight of His Chains? We can. Grabbed right there, Milan. Going to be stuck. Speaking of being stuck, though, S4 as well, just right next to him. Even a Static Storm committed for this one. But there he goes. Godlike streak now for Kuroki's Ember Spirit. 44-30. Secret
Klinks
stopped
mid.
Their push down mid lane, but look at this guy. Here's Klinks. They know something's up. They're pinging it out.
Oh, that was a mistake.
Immediate chains. Ice Blast. Oh, no. Pops his BKB and TP. He does make it out. Makes it out. No glimpse going to be there, obviously, because of the BKB. And oh, cheeky play, but Secret were ready.
I don't know why he's still going on the HNF Burst. He knows he has the Ghost Scepter. He's used it on him like three times. So awkward. I thought he'd just get some damage into the racks, but of course that would have been regen too, as the response team was there. Kuro is able to bounce back and forth across the map very nicely. I was talking about this very early on, but when you're up against the Lycan and the Visage, you want something global. You want something that moves across the map, and Ember and HNF Burst can both contribute globally. Now Booktop getting picked off by a nice little glimpse, and that should be the top lane to racks, though they only have one Ravage to fight for it.
Puppy showing off those fancy red shoes. The Boots of Travel brings him to mid lane, and the second he comes in, they just pull out the glimpse Ice Blast, and it's like nothing you can really do about it. Now going again towards these tier 4s. These stunning birds trying what they, the damn well they can to slow them down. And even the glyph coming out. I don't think there's a whole lot much more they could do, but this is potentially the last fight. Moving forward, charging. BKB, Wolfman, running right towards Kuroki, chasing him all the way out in the base and away, while Simba continues to just go right for the throne. And now chased out, S4 moves out from the bottom ground, and Simba returns right back. Gets stunned up from those birds not once, but twice. And puts his sights right onto the throne itself. Yes, there's a fight potentially happening here on the outside, but Dota's a game of taking down the base, and Simba's trying to do that for his team. Gets caught up right now with the Chrono and could go down. Big soul assumption, big damage, but the Ravage coming through just in the nick of time from S4. Saving about, and he's going to get his own double kill. Void goes down, then does Visage, locking him down into a pit of death with a kinetic field as Big Daddy. And very, very well-wounded Lycanthrope. A few more right-clicks could finish him off right here. Oh! They are able to get it. Simba does end up falling. Now Klinks brings out the right-click. The Ice Blast does connect on the last two survivors, however. Secret, move back in. S4, Anchor Smash, Rubick dies. Klinks also gonna go down. One last buyback coming out from Rubick just to see his throne go down. It's gonna be Team Secret who get another big win here and finish out their day 2-0.
Indeed, that was just a hell of a game from Team Secret. I really love the style, the strat in general. It really fits the team, meshes with them very well, and they found a lot of great opportunities to put it to use. I'm not so sure with the MYI draft. We talked